Karkati. 14 people got it right. Only three of you all who have missed it. Can you, Karkati, can you remember this for cucumber? Draksha was grapes and cucumber is Karkati. Okay. So learning for me also. And I think Krishna Chinta, you have come up and the rest of them remain the same. Can we move on to the third question? Right. What is the Sanskrit word for pineapple? Akulam, Annaphalam, Anasphalam, Adrakam, Anasphalam, Alukam. Okay, everybody got it right. All of them almost. Just one person missed it. Can somebody unmute and pronounce this correctly? And that will be great.
Ananas is pineapple.
Okay.
Ananasaphalam.
Okay. Ananasaphalam. Wonderful. Thank you so much. So we learned cucumber, grapes. And then Karkati is cucumber. Draksha is grape. And then pineapple is, can somebody say ananas? Okay, I'm trying to also put it into my memory. Good job, guys. Thank you so much. Okay, hey, wow. This is like almost all of you all have gone up and okay, let's see who the top five winners are. Krishna Chinta, OV, Magical Fairy Eve, Super Saki, Dragon HK, and YP has a streak with 3 correct answers in a row. Wonderful. Congratulations, guys. And all of you all, I mean, you're also doing, it's just a question of time, I think. Some people do it more quicker than others, but most of you all got it right because all these 3 questions, I saw that everybody got it right. Most of all. What is the Sanskrit word for okra? Bindika, Grinjanam, Jambiram. Okay, 17 people got it right. It is Bindika. That is okra. Okra, do you all know what okra is?
Yeah. It's like a lady finger. It's lady finger.
Correct, correct. Okay, good job, guys. All right, Super Suki has come up and she's got the highest streak of 4, which means she's got 4 correct answers. I'm sorry, let's see. 5th question. What is the Sanskrit word for eggplant? Panasam, Vrintakam, Palakya. Eggplant. Vrintakam. And 12 people got it right. One of them missed. Vrintakam. Am I pronouncing it correct? Somebody wants to say this?
Yes, eggplant.
Okay, good. All right. So we have, what did we learn so far? Can you say or I'll try to recollect?
Draksha, ananas, palam, bindika.
And cucumber.
Cucumber, Karkati.
Karkati. Okay, and eggplant. Vrintakam. Okay, good job, guys. In fact, in childhood, you know, I used to play this game. And Ramachandra is the highest climber. He is up 3 places. Krishna Chinta is leading. OV, we have Dragon HK. He has come up. Congratulations. Magical Fairy. And then we have YP. She has also come up. Congratulations, guys. And congratulations, Ramachandra. Awesome. 6th question, okay. What is the Sanskrit word for fruit? Tubhyam, Sakam, Phalam. Even I know this for a change. Even I know the answer for this. Wonderful. All 18 got it. Congratulations. Superb. Phalam, right? Okay. Krishna Chinta, Ovi, Dragon. I mean, they are the same set of people. Okay. Dragon HK, he has a streak with 6 correct answers in a row. Okay, great job. Let us go on to the next question. 7th question. What is the Sanskrit word for vegetable? We saw fruit and now it is vegetable. Oh, wow, wonderful. Sakam, you got it right and only one person missed it. Is it Sakam or can you pronounce this, somebody?
Shakam.
Shakam, okay. So, the fruit is Shakam and Shakam is vegetable. We saw some fruits like Draksha, pineapple, and we saw some vegetables like eggplant. What else did we see? Cucumber.
Bindika.
And bindika. Cucumber is karkati, right? Karkati. And anas, what is it? Anas, pineapple is?
Ananas phalam,
yeah. Okay, good. And what is the eggplant? What is it called?
Vrintakam.
Vrintakam, okay. I'm also trying to recollect. Thank you for helping me out. Vrintakam, I forgot that actually. Gobinda, you are making a comeback with 3 in a row. Congratulations, Gobinda. And King of Gods, he has come up. And top 5 winners, congratulations. Hare Krishna to you. Let's move on to the next question. 8th question. What is the Sanskrit for this in feminine gender? Asia, etat. So it is Asia and that is the meaning of this. Okay, can we move on to the next question? Does this in feminine gender actually? What is it in masculine gender? Anybody wants to say?
Asia.
Okay. Sorry.
I'm going to go to that one.
8th question.
Out of 10?
Yeah. I'm so sorry. Okay, we'll go to the 9th question now. And there's something that we have for King of Gods. Has this. Okay, 8 answers. He got it correct in a row. Congratulations, King of Gods. I'm sure all of you here who are up here in the top 5, you all have it right. And most of you all who are not on top 5, you may also be obviously getting all the answers correct. So I definitely appreciate all your efforts. Okay. Thank you so much. We will move on to the next question, which is the 9th question. What is the English word for raktaphalam? Apple, tomato or strawberry? Raktaphalam. People got it right. The answer is tomato. Does somebody want to explain this? Raktaphalam.
Raktaphalam because it's
raktaphalam is tomato.
Tomato. No, no. I just thought, do you have an explanation?
Raktaphalam is red because phalam.
Red. Wonderful. Exactly. I wanted an explanation. Thank you, Gobinda. Wonderful. And Magical Fairy, you've come up. YP has a streak with 9 correct answers in a row. Great job. Last question for today. What is the English word for Narikelaha. Orange, coconut, onion. Okay, 16 people got it right. Narikelaha. Okay, does some, I mean, I also know this, but do you have an explanation here? Do you want to share if there is an explanation?
Narikelaha is coconut because it's brown.
It's brown, okay. Okay, guys, are we ready to see?
Is Mexico,
isn't Narikelaha coconut?
What is
Nari?
Narikelaha is Vaseline, that's why.
In Hindi, Nariyal means coconut, so that's why I chose.
Okay, good job. In Hindi, Nariyal means coconut, and that's why we are getting it from Hindi here, okay?
And in
Did somebody have to add to it? Are we good? All right, guys, we will see the scores, the top five winners. And the third place goes to Magical Fairy. Congratulations. Dragon HK, second place. And first place goes to Krishna Chintam. Runner-up, YP and King of Gods, I think. Congratulations. Hare Krishna to you guys. Okay, we'll go to the report and check the report out, okay? Okay, we have seen top five winners. Now Ramachandra, sixth place with 90%. OV, Gobinda, Super Saki, Obliterator, Hare Krishna, Ananya, Radha, Kushi, Adya, Kumudini, Aryan, and Mickey. Mickey didn't play, of course, I think. Okay. All right, guys. Congratulations. Any questions before we move to Srimad Bhagavatam? Are we good?
Good.
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 Okay.
Good.
Okay, let's move on then. We will start to play Kahoot for Srimad Bhagavatam. Are you all ready? If you want to reset it, please reset. I'm going to give you 1 minute. Please do that. Are we all ready, guys?
Yes.
No.
Okay, just take your time. I'll give you 1 minute. As soon as the clock here says 4:24, I will get started.
What is the game pin?
Yes, I'm going to give you in a minute. As you see, I'm not yet moved to the screen for game pin, but I'm going to do that now. Okay, it's 364-9755. I see 15 players so far. We'll give it one more minute. So I think at least 19 players would join, right?
Sixteen.
There's 18 players in the session.
17.
No, but two are the co-host or host.
Okay, can you get started? I think 19 players are here.
Yeah.
So we all, you know, I'm thinking we will do few questions, then I'll give you a brief overview about that story. And then like that, we will go ahead, okay? But first few questions, I will not be saying.
Can you wait like for 1 minute, Mataji, because like I'm.
Okay, no problem, Kumudini. Join, I'll wait for you. Whenever you join, let me know though. Kumudini, you joined, right? Kumu, you're in, right? That is the thing I saw now. Can I get started?
Yeah.
The first question in Srimad Bhagavatam. From which river did the Pandavas offer water to their dead relatives? Yamuna, Ganga and Saraswati. It is Ganga, and we have 14 people who got this right, and only, you know, few people did miss it. Okay, we will move on. Right, we are seeing Aditya is reading next, followed by Krishna Chinta, Ramachandra, Ovi, and Charit. Second question for today. What did the Pandavas do after reaching the bank of the river? They went for a bath, they went for swimming, they went for boating. What did they do?
Swimming. Mm. Went boating. Oh, nice.
18 people got it right. All right. That is right. Went for a bath. Okay, Ovi, you have come up. Congratulations. Magical Fairy, the highest climber. Congratulations, Magical Fairy Beast. Awesome. And the top five winners otherwise remain the same. Who tried to pacify the Pandavas? Vidhyashra, Sukadev Goswami, the Lord Krishna and the sages. Who did that?
I don't know this.
Got it right. That is Lord Krishna and the sages. One person missed it. Okay, we will move on. After maybe like 8 questions, we can discuss the story and see how it goes. Aditya, I mean the same set of top 5. Magical Fairy Bees just hit an answer streak of 3. Congratulations, Magical Fairy. The fourth question in Srimad Bhagavatam. The cousins of Pandavas are moral, immoral, saintly. Who are the cousins of Pandavas? Think through that and then answer the question.
What does moral mean?
Moral means good. I mean, they follow good conduct.
Okay.
They
what is immoral?
Yes? Immoral. They were not following good conduct. Duryodhana, Kauravas. I mean, you know, he was so angry, envious. Jealous and arrogant. Those are things that, and then, you know, he tried to kill the Pandavas many times in the forest. He tried to poison Bhima. And then there was a fire of, I mean, there was a house and then they.
Wax house.
Yeah, wax house, and he was trying to burn them down. So likewise, Duryodhana did lot of things that was not.
And he made them go to exile.
Yeah.
And then Duryodhana told Dushajan to take the sari off from Draupadi.
Yeah, that was again immoral because, you know, remember he pulled the hair of Draupadi and he brought her to the court and then stripped off her sari and that time Draupadi was, you know, super, she was in such a mess and she didn't have anybody to help her. Bhishma, nobody came forward to help her, and then she surrendered herself to Lord Krishna and Krishna saved her. Like that, I mean, they, even though Kauravas happened to do so many things to Pandavas, they were always taking the Pandavas, they were always taking the shelter of Krishna, because of which all the things, you know, whatever happened to them, they didn't feel the pain because of that reason. Krishna was always with them at all points of time. Okay? Right. The same set of top five. Congratulations, Sridham, with four correct answers in a row. Congratulations, Sridhama. Wonderful job. Can we move on to the next question? Fifth question. Everybody born in this material world dies. Is that a true statement or a false statement? Sometimes only. It is a true statement. Everybody, if somebody is born in this material world, they have to die. Because the body is it a permanent thing? Is body permanent?
No.
Body is not permanent. It is temporary. Which is permanent and which is eternal? The always soul. There. The soul.
The soul.
Awesome. Awesome. I love your answers. The soul is permanent, but the material body is not permanent. It is temporary. And that is why Krishna was asking Arjuna to fight in the war, because he said, you know, this anyways, they have to lose their body. Their body is temporary, but the soul is permanent. So that was one of the reasons Krishna provided Arjuna and told Arjuna, you should fight in the war and not shy away from by not participating in the war. Govinda, congratulations. You have answer streak of five. And we have the top five winners here. Congratulations. They remain the same. Sixth question. Who was very famous throughout the world after performing three horse sacrifices? Ashwatthama, Arjuna, or King Yudhishthira? He performed three horse sacrifices. Who was that? Okay, 15% got it right. That is King Yudhishthira, which is the right answer. He was the one who performed three horse sacrifices. After eight or maybe 10 questions, we'll try to recap of the story. And I'll try to teach you some concepts from that story. Okay?
Wait, what's a horse sacrifice?
The horse sacrifice is done so that, I mean, he has to capture the world, right? And for that, sacrifices are performed so he can capture the world. And you see, if you look at Indra, he performed 100 horse sacrifices. And so Krishna wanted Yudhishthira also to become famous like Indra. And he said, by doing these sacrifices, you will also become famous and you can conquer the world.
Wait, killing the horse or like bringing the horse somewhere?
What is that?
Like, do they kill the horse or do they serve the horse?
They actually, I don't know. I think they take the horse. They take the horses to so many places, and that way they capture the world. I think.
No. The horse take to each kingdom. That's
why.
And then.
Oh yeah. The horse takes.
The king doesn't like it. Then
the king assigns the horse like with the prince, and then like roam around kingdoms to rule it.
Yes. So they take the horses, I mean, to the different kingdoms, and through that they capture that particular kingdom. That is what is done in that process.
I have a question.
Yes.
Are horse sacrifices same as Ashwamedh Yajna?
No, these are not same like Ashwamedh Yajna.
Okay.
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 Varun, you have come up. Ovi, you have also come up. Krishna Chintra, you have the highest answer streak of six. sorry, Ashwamedha Yajna and horse sacrifice, they mean the same thing. Yeah, I meant to say was Indra did 100 Ashwamedha Yajna. And here Yudhishthira, he has done 3 Ashwamedha Yajna. And remember Prithu Maharaj, he has done 99 and he was asked to stop by Brahma to say that, you know, don't do the 100th sacrifice. Immediately Prithu Maharaj agreed to it and he take care of that request that Brahma had for him. Because he wanted to go through the will of the Lord. The will of the Lord was that he wanted to do only 99. And Indra, at that time, he was creating lot of trouble and stop Prithu from doing the 100th sacrifice also. He was creating so many troubles. He came in the disguise. He did want to stop, and then his Prithu Maharaj's son intervened. He then tried to rescue him. And because this Ashwamedha Yajna, they have to go on continuously. This person, whoever is starting off, they should not get distracted and go somewhere else or get angry. They have to remain in a very calm mood. They have to be peaceful. They have to follow their they have to follow all the code of conduct very religiously. Then only that Ashwamedha Yajna is completed. It is horse sacrifice. It's also called har sacrifice. Okay? And Indra did 100. Prithu Maharaj did 99. Here Yudhishthira, he did 3 sacrifices. Okay? 7th question. Lord Krishna was ready to go to his own city, which is Vrindavan, Dwaraka, Mathura. Dwaraka, yes. And, oh my God, very good scores. Aditya, Krishna Chinta, Ramachandra, Varun the Carrot, and YP. We all see that they have come up. And do we have any? Okay, Magical Fairy Beads. You also have 7 answers right in a row. Congratulations. Okay, 8th question. Who worshipped Lord Krishna when he was leaving for Dwaraka? Srila Vyasadev, Sutta Goswami, Sukadev Goswami.
Mataji, I don't think he told us this.
Oh, he didn't? Oh.
Yes. He told Krishna was already leaving. He told Shri Vyasadeva is doing worship.
Did he teach in the class? He probably would have because okay. Yeah. Maybe you were missing it or something you would have just stepped out at that time. The video is probably on YouTube and you can definitely check out. If not, you're learning in this process. That's okay.
Oh, no.
Are you guys okay? Can we move on to the next question? Yes?
Yes.
Okay. Charit has come up. Magical Fairy Beast has come up. And Magical Fairy, you've got 8 correct in a row. Congratulations, top 5 winners. Totally appreciate what you're doing. Who was running towards Krishna when he was preparing to leave? Queen Kunti, Draupadi, Uttara. Okay, Uttara. Okay. We'll see the story soon. After 10 questions, we'll definitely try to do a recap so far. What did we learn? I'm just going through because if I'm going to talk something, then I'll start revealing some details for the next question. That's why I don't want to interrupt the flow. Okay. Hopefully we will do it after a few questions and then talk through this so you understand. Charit, Magical Fairy Bees, you have come up and up. Okay, Ovi, congratulations. Keep it up. 10th question. Who fired the iron arrow to kill the baby in the womb of Uttara? Ashwatthama, Kripacharya, Kritavarma. Okay, all of you all got it right. Only one person probably missed this question, and hopefully he knows the answer is Ashwatthama. We'll go through that story as I told you. Just a couple of more things. Aditya, you have 10 correct answers. Congratulations, Aditya. Keep it up. Okay. 11th question. What was the fiery arrow called? Brahmastra, Nayanastra, Pasupat. Brahmastra. Okay, here are the revised scores. The same top five. OV is making a comeback with 3 in a row. You'll see one more question. What did Krishna do when the Pandavas were in danger? Took his Sudarshan disc to protect them, took his club to protect them, took the sword to protect them.
He got it wrong.
Took his Sudarshan disc to protect them. So first we'll see. So there was a lamentation because there were the Pandavas completed the war and they saw that a lot of people died in the war. So Pandavas along with Draupadi, they went to the Ganges. They offered water to the departed souls and lamented for them and took a bath in the holy river. Okay. And who pacified the Pandavas? Draupadi, Kunti and Gandhari. They were overwhelmed with grief and Lord Krishna and the sages pacified them by suggesting that all these living entities, they are obviously it's temporary and because of stringent laws of material nature and time, they have to go and that is the destiny. Like that, Pandavas were pacified by the sages and Lord Krishna. After that, what happened? Lord Krishna's grace, Maharaj Yudhishthira recovered his kingdom after killing the cunning Duryodhana and his associates whose lives were diminished because of rough handling of Draupadi's hair. Not only that, there were many incidents like poisoning, trying to kill them in the Vanavas time and trying to burn them out, trying to poison Bhima. So many incidents happened and now Yudhishthira happened to come back to the power all because of Krishna by killing Duryodhana and others. Okay, Lord Krishna then had Yudhishthira perform 3 horse sacrifices and thus caused his fame to be like that of Indra's. As I told you, he wanted him to be also famous, so he asked him to perform Ashwamedha Yajna or the horse sacrifice. And now Uttara is crying out for help. What did she say? Lord Krishna, he then prepared for his departure, going back to Dwaraka. After exchanging greetings with the Brahmanas and Pandavas, he sat on a chariot. And Uttara then came running towards him in fear and addressed him. Oh Lord, Lord of the universe, in this world I have nobody except you to protect me from the clutches of death. And then there is this fiery arrow that is coming towards me very fast. Let it burn me, I don't care. But it should not burn or kill my embryo. Please Krishna, save me. Like that Uttara came running towards who? Krishna. And now Krishna understood that Ashwatthama had released one or many of the Brahmastras. Seeing the glaring Brahmastra coming towards him, the Pandavas took up their weapons. And what did Krishna do? Krishna, he then took up his Sudarshana disc to protect the Pandavas, his unalloyed devotees. The Pandavas never expected anything from Krishna. But Krishna, he knows that they are pure devotees and that's why he wanted to extend his help by protecting them through the Sudarshana Chakra. And Lord Krishna is also called Yogeshwara and Paramatma, then covered Uttara's embryo with his personal energy. And that is what he did. And what did he also do? He also counteracted the Brahmastra and neutralized them. So the Brahmastra now did not attack, because it was neutralized by this Sudarshana Chakra from Krishna. And that is what he did. That is all. His powers are so inconceivable. We cannot understand what all he can do because the whole world operates under him. He is the creator, he is the maintainer, and he is the destroyer. Also, the Sudarshana Chakra, when it came for protection, we should remember our chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra is also like Sudarshana Chakra. It will protect us on all sides. It will protect above, here, on the sides, and everywhere else. So chanting is so, so powerful. We should always remember to chant the holy names whenever we are in trouble. At trouble, we should not say, Krishna, why is this happening to me? At trouble, we have to say, Krishna, it is okay, it happened to me. It is all because of me and my mistakes, it happened to me. But I will never want to forget your association of the holy name. And you should always keep chanting. And then he thus saved the Pandavas. And Draupadi also offered her obeisances to him. And after that, what happened? Kunti offered her prayers to Krishna, and Kunti prayers were spoken. I hope you covered that in the class. And Kunti prayers, after Kunti prayers, we would see about what else? I think we will see about Yudhishthira's lamentation. What did Yudhishthira lament for? So we will see that after a few more questions. So far we have seen the lamentation of the Pandavas, and what did Krishna do to pacify them, and what happened with the story of Ashwatthama, and how did Krishna protect Uttarasum. Okay? Are you all good so far?
Yes.
Okay, let's move on. We have, the same set of top five. I'm not going to repeat. 8 players hit the ancestry 3, meaning I think they got 3 in a row or something like that. Govinda means one who brings happiness to the rivers, cows, sages. Cows. And this month is Purushottama month, and if you are doing any charities to the cows, that is a very, very nice thing. And as much as possible, this month is very auspicious, because Krishna says that if you're doing charity in this month, charity to the cows in this month, he will feel very happy about it. So to please Krishna, you can ask your parents to do some charity to the cows. If you have cows nearby, you can go and visit them, feed them grass, banana, or whatever they would eat. You can definitely have that experience in a goshala. It is good if you have any goshalas nearby, or you stay close to the temple. That's also great. We have Ramachandra and Mickey. They have come up, and 8 players hit the answer streak. How much? 4. Okay, guys, 14th question. Krishna saved his mother Devaki from Brahmastra, prison of Kauravas, prison of King Kamsa. Here, so Krishna saved Devaki from imprisonment by Kamsa. And Kunti here says that you have actually saved my children from series of dangers that have come to my son. So she's talking about the poison plague. She's talking about the house that was going to be burned by the fire. That time Krishna saved them. She saved them in the gambling. Krishna saved them in the gambling batch when Draupadi was suffering. And then during the exile, they were tried. There were multiple attempts of Duryodhana trying to kill the Pandavas. That time Krishna helped them. And then there were so many great fighters in the war. And Krishna helped them with Krishna being the charioteer, he actually provided guidance to Arjuna and helped them overcome all the difficulties with the great fighters, with the weapons and so on and so forth. And now you're also trying to help us out with this weapon. So there are so many dangers that come to us, but because of you, Krishna, we are able to come out of it. And she says that let the calamities come again and again to us, and that way we will constantly be able to remember you, Krishna. Because sometimes when we are happy, we may tend to forget Krishna. So Kunti was in such a mood that she wants to see Krishna all the time. And because Krishna was there in each and every suffering of theirs, she thinks, let the calamities... She didn't want Krishna to basically go to Dwaraka, and she kind of wants to stop him. And she says, let the calamity come to us again and again so we can see. Okay? We have 2 more questions. Let's go. Right. We have Gobinda, you have an answer streak of 14 correct answers. Congratulations, Gobinda. I think you are listening very well in Srimad Bhagavatam class. And all the top five winners, you're doing a great job, because I totally appreciate your efforts. Who saved Pandavas many times from different dangers? Lord Krishna, Lord Shiva, Bhishma. Sorry, Bhishma Deva. Okay, this is an easy answer. We just now talked through it and you all got it right. I'm so happy. Okay. Congratulations, guys. Top five winners, they remain the same. The last question for today. Why did Kunti want dangers to come again and again? So that Krishna could go away, so that Pandavas could stay together, so that she could see Krishna again and again. I kind of revealed the answer, I believe. But that's okay. Hopefully, you'll get it all right if you listen to me. Oh, three people missed it. Yeah, so she wanted Krishna to... mysteries again and again, because she wanted to see Krishna again and again. You can also see the word again and again used. Maybe that can be a hint also. All right, let's go on to the scores. Are you all good? Can we see the scores and the top five winners and then move on to the report? Yeah? Third place goes to Charit.
Good.
Krishna Chinta, second place. And first place goes to Aditya. Congratulations. And Rama Chinta and Mickey are fourth and fifth place. Congratulations, guys. Wonderful job. You'll go on to the report. Wonderful playing Kahoot. And we did learn so many things today. Okay, we saw the top five. Sixth place is Magical Fairy. Varun the Carrot is seventh place. Siddham is eighth. Ninth is Gobinda. You got 100%. Gobind, good job. And even in the top,
yes.
I mean, wonderful. You got 100%. And what else? YP, Obliterator, OV, Adya, Ananya, Kushi, Hare Krishna, Mishi, Kumu, Aryan and Kumu again. Okay, that's pretty much it. Yes.
Well, I did not play on the two.
I know, you didn't play on the two. Yeah. I see that. Okay. Anyway, good job, guys. Congratulations. Think we are done with today's Kahoot. And let's offer our obedience.
Why I did got 100? Because I was from